is not widely known. She has been referred to as a famous stranger and labeled the Madonna of Song. Her melodies are familiar, yet her name is not. She overcame racism and gender bias during a pivotal era in American music history to become the first commercially successful Mexican female composer. She was a pioneer of music during the first half of the 20th century, working alongside some of the greatest artists of these decades. Her life and music deserve rediscovery. Composer and singer Nayeli Nesme states, "To recover the works of Maria Grieber is to recover the sound memories of Mexico and of the world." And that Grieber's music is an aesthetic, emotional, sociological, and cultural reference because her music has gained a wide exposure from the popular to the academic fields. Although Grieber does not have the same instant name recognition as some of her contemporaries, her body of work is extensive, and her personal story of persistence and resourcefulness deserves acknowledgement. Grieber was born Maria Joaquina de la Portilla Torres in Mexico to a Spanish father and a Mexican mother. Although many publications differ on her birth date, her family archives record September 14, 1885 as accurate. Her father took the family to Europe in 1888, where they lived in Madrid. During their time in Europe, she studied piano, violin, and voice, composed songs, sang opera, and developed her musicianship. Grieber learned English, Spanish, French, and Italian. The family spent time in London and Paris, where she worked with Claude Debussy and Franz Lehár. Grieber wrote almost exclusively in Spanish and felt a duty to maintain her cultural identity. Her colorful, heartfelt music adds distinctiveness and variety to a recital program. Grieber's songs offer a high level of musical integrity and socio-cultural value. Her experience and training in classical music is reflected in her compositions that are sophisticated and maintain the color and cultural authenticity of her native Mexico. The programming of modern recitals is evolving, and more songs written for stage and screen are being presented alongside standard classical repertoire. Grieber's music bridges the classical and popular genres in seamless fashion. The songs presented in this project are of varying skill levels and highlight different features concerning melodic contour, vocal range, phrasing, depth of accompaniment, and expression. Grieber was classically trained but adapted to the styles and genres of her time. In this manner, her music serves as a natural bridge between classical and popular or crossover genres. Grieber's life was fraught with personal hardship, and she told her story through song texts. Jurame had a significant impact on the Latin American population and was extremely popular. It is traditionally sung by tenors but can also be sung by sopranos. Comparable to an operatic aria, Jurame could be a beautiful addition to a recital or masterclass. Te Quiero Dijiste was published in 1930 and follows Grieber's pattern of composing in binary form. It is a beautiful, sincere song with a manageable range and offers opportunities for effective interpretation. Stacked chords provide depth to the orchestration. The vocal line, however, is simple and repetitive, and the text is tender, descriptive, and intimate. next major commercial success came in 1934, Cuando Vuelva Tu Lado was quite popular in Latin America, but also had great success in the United States when it was translated into English as What a Difference a Day Makes, and recorded by Frank Sinatra and Bing Crosby, among many others. In 1959, Dinah Washington won a Grammy Award for her interpretation of this song and was inducted into the Grammy Hall of Fame in 1998. It seems fitting that a woman of color would gain recognition from performing a piece by Maria Grever, since she was such a pioneer for minority women. The marriage of the sensual text combined with a colorful harmony and legato line makes the song very romantic. Cuando Vuelva Tu Lado is a lovely song, and with its moderate tempo, octave range, stepwise motion, and intimate text, it is very accessible to singers. In 1941, one of her most popular songs was Volveré. In Volveré, the woman is free and cannot be contained, which is symbolized by the butterflies or mariposas. The man is fixed and steady, represented by the beach or playa. The strong-willed woman also determines when she will return to the man. Grever's poetry was bold and empowered women with her compositions. Volveré. Thank you. Weaver spent the 1940s writing new songs, composing for film scores, and publishing her own music. Her popularity grew as more performers presented her works in concert. One of her great boleros, Así, was written in 1946. This beautiful song offers pedagogical opportunities to encourage the singer to a legato line and spin in a sustained passage, as well as interpretively using the changes in tonality to inform the portrayal of a character. Así. Despedida is from the album Six Songs by Maria Griever. The collection of songs was published in 1946 by Griever's own Portilla Music Corporation in New York. The most widely known song from the album is Despedida and was written in ternary form, which is interesting since Griever typically wrote in binary form. Pedagogically, Despedida is more dramatic and demanding than some of her other pieces and would be best sung by a full voice capable of navigating high and low notes of their range and able to passionately communicate the dramatic, heartfelt text, Despedida. Thank you. April of 1948, Griever suffered a stroke that left half her body paralyzed. She faced difficult health issues, but they did not stop her from composing and performing until her death in 1951. Maria Griever was resilient, multi-talented, and innovative. She was a wife and mother, as well as an accomplished artist. Griever faced personal hardship, heartbreak, and loss, but never gave up. Studying Griever's music provides pedagogical opportunities to singers of varying levels of ability as they explore Spanish language songs. Griever's life is not only inspirational on a personal level, but is also a lesson on establishing brand identity, resourcefulness, and living with unfailing tenacity. The studio and stage will be enriched by her music and may lead to continued interest in Latin American repertoire. Incorporating Griever's compositions into a singer's vocal repertoire is an excellent way to broaden the scope of styles and languages while maintaining the highest standards of musical study. Thank you.